So starting with centroid and moment of inertia, why, first of all, let us say, ask this question that why do we actually need to find out? Look, in your, just going a little back, when we were studying shear force and bending moment diagram, I told you that uniformly distributed load behaves as a rectangle. I mean, it can be seen as a rectangle. Constant load over a fixed distance. So if you have constant load over a fixed distance, then it will behave as a rectangle. So that is the centroid of a rectangle. We have assumed it as L by 2. Similarly, for a triangle, we said that it will be L by 3 from the larger end and 2L by 3 from the smaller end. So these are statements we had made. So, centroid, the specific definition of centroid is, it is a location either inside or outside the body. Or outside the body, where the entire area is assumed to be concentrated. So centroid is a location, either it can also lie outside the body. There are structures where the centroid lies outside the body. Okay, I'll show you with the help of some examples that the centroid actually lies outside the body. So centroid is a location either inside or outside the body where the entire area is assumed to be concentrated. Center of mass. Center of mass where entire mass is assumed to be concentrated. So what is mass? Mass is the total amount of matter contained in a body. So center of mass, it is a location either inside or outside the body where the entire mass is assumed to be concentrated. Similarly, center of gravity, where the entire weight is assumed to be concentrated. So these are three terms that we come across in our day-to-day life. The purpose is, if we want to represent that entire body as a point, let us say we had a rectangle, let us say we had a triangle, and if we want to represent the entire body as a point, then you cannot place it anywhere. It is not about drawing a free body diagram. It is about represent. In a free body diagram, what you do is you represent the body as a point, and you why do we represent it? Because you want to convert it into a coplanar concurrent force system. The purpose is to convert it into a coplanar concurrent force system. Whereas here, if you want to represent it as a point, then the purpose is that we need to define a point which is either inside or outside the body, where one of these parameters is assumed to be concentrated, means that the entire weight, mass or area can be assumed that this is one location where it is concentrated. Now, this is not merely an assumption. A body actually behaves about its centroid, center of mass and center of gravity also. It is not merely about assumption, means we cannot exactly say this statement that it is assumed. Why do we write this statement? In this entire statement, assumed is, there are some intricate shapes for which we actually assume the centroid. We are not able to find it out. So we assume the centroid. So the definition is, in most of the cases, it is the location where the body, the entire mass, area or weight is assumed to be concentrated. So coming back to all these three terms, if you look at centroid, center of mass and center of gravity, we generally deal with centroid only. The reason is, there are a few reasons. First, we neglect the self weight of the mass. So when we neglect the self weight of the body, obviously weight does not come into picture. ठीक है. Now let us understand why do we neglect the self weight of the body. We neglect the self weight of the body because we are designing structures, bodies, components such that it is able to handle a very huge amount of force as compared to its own weight. So let us say you have a beam which is of weight 2 ton and it is actually handling a weight of 100 tons. So if you consider the body for its structural analysis, you will take it as 102 tons. Otherwise, if you do not consider its own weight, you will take it as 100 tons only. So there is not a remarkable difference between 100 ton and 102 ton. So what we do is, the best way out is, we neglect the self weight of the body. So neglecting the self weight of the body does not make any harm, whereas the advantage lies that it makes your problem remarkably simpler. Because if you neglect the weight of the body, you are just not neglecting the stored 2 tons, you are neglecting the material of the body. Okay, so material weight means it is due to a certain material. If it is a certain material, it has material properties, it will behave according to its material properties, and this is the reason why it will make your problem very, very difficult if you consider the self weight of the body. So let us say that you have an iron beam of weight and you are considering the weight of the body. So if you, once you say iron beam and you are considering the weight of the body, what will now happen? You need to know which grade of iron it is, what are its properties, you need to put down the properties. Now, if it is iron of a poor grade, that you need to understand or also use the impurities or the drawbacks due to the pure improper formation of this iron or impure grade of this iron. So lot of material classification, ya fir aap ye samjho, pura material science sab kuch isme aa jayega. You have started the problem with design and actually you end with material science and material characterization. So to eliminate this, hum karte kya hai ki self weight of the body is neglected. Theek hai. Aur amuman mechanical engineering ho gaya, civil engineering ho gaya, self weight does not play a big role. So where does it play? ऐसा तो है नहीं कि फॉर ऑल स्ट्रक्चर्स फॉर एवरी वेयर यू कैन नेग्लेक्ट इट. सो सेंटर ऑफ मास, सेंटर ऑफ मास और यू से सेंटर ऑफ वेट, सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी, दीज टू प्ले अ रोल इन aerospace engineering. They play a role in aerospace engineering, they play a role in marine engineering, they play a role in technology related to medical. So these are few examples where you can say that these center of mass or center of gravity you cannot neglect. So you have to keep them in mind. Aerospace weight or weight is a very big factor. Marine again weight is a very big factor. And if you say technology related to medical terms, again weight is a very big factor, because suppose let us say you have to embed a instrument which with the help of a robot or guiding it from outside, it will go inside your body and perform certain tests or operations. So in that case, the self weight of the body is equally important. But for all other major applications, large size applications, the self weight of the body is neglected. So the next step involves that how do we calculate these centroids? So to calculate the centroid, what we are doing is let us first, so now let us calculate the centroid. So this is the primary reason why civil engineering and mechanical engineering, we are not bothered about center of gravity or center of mass until and unless a specific situation arises. Otherwise, we are very fine with calculating centroid only. Okay, so now let us calculate the centroid of bodies. So to calculate the centroid of bodies, what we are doing is, let us say that we'll be applying Vergnon's theorem. So let us say calculation of centroid is application of Vergnon's theorem. So let us say you have some structure. So let us divide it into, because the definition of centroid now says that it is the point either inside or outside the body where the entire area is assumed to be concentrated. So you are actually playing around with areas. So let us divide it into some areas. Let it be any area. This is A1. This is A2, this is A3, and this is A4, and this is A5. So these are five areas which you have. Let us say that the assumed centroid of this, from this reference level, from the y-axis, let us say y becomes your reference level. X1 is the centroid of A1. From the reference, from the same reference level, X2 is the centroid for A3, we have X3, and for A4, we have X4, and correspondingly for A5, you have A5. So these are the five centroids with reference to a central reference axis. Okay. So now these are rough arbitrary structures, and you know that this is the centroid. So Vergnon's theorem says that the sum of moment produced by all individual forces is equal to the moment produced by the resultant taken about the same point. In this entire statement, you remove force, add areas. So if you are adding areas by removal of force, then how will you say this statement? The sum of moment of areas taken about a reference point for individual areas is equal to the moment of the resultant area taken about that same point. So if you write this statement in your own words, this becomes A1 X1. This is moment of area of body A1 with reference to the reference axis. This is your reference axis. Plus A2 X2 plus A3 X3 plus A4 X4 plus A5 X5. So this is the sum of moment of area is taken about a reference point. This is equal to the moment of the resultant area. So the resultant area is capital A. And let the centroid of this entire section, this rigid structure, lie at a distance of x bar, where x bar is the centroid of the entire section, centroid of the entire section. From the reference point. From the reference point. So if you write this statement, this becomes in integral terms, this can be written as integral this is a dx divided by sorry, let us reduce it one step further. If you reduce it one step further, this can be written as sigma a1 sorry by a1 sigma ax from I is equal to 1 to I is equal to n is equal to ax bar. So x bar is equal to a by so x bar is equal to integral ax by summation of ax by a. This can be further written as integral x dA divided by integral dA. So this is another form of if you write it in integral terms, it is integral x dA divided by integral dA. Okay. Because the areas are also not known and the centroid is also known. So these are two forms of representing this. So similarly, if you take reference with respect to this point, if you take reference with this respect to this point, this will be discretized into areas in the y-axis. So let us say that this is your reference axis and this is a arbitrary structure. So let us divide it into areas like this. So with reference to this axis, let us say y1 is the area, centroid for area a1, y2 is the centroid for area a2, and similarly for a3, you have y3. So again, if you determine the centroid, y bar, by similar ways, it is integral yda divided by integral dA, or you can write this as integral ay divided by integral a. So these are few ways of determining the centroid with reference to x axis or y axis or any chosen arbitrary axis, because it is not only about x axis and y axis, it is about any arbitrary axis. You choose any arbitrary axis, sara khel distance lene ka hai. Distance aap kahan se lenge, ye aapki choice hai. Distance kitni hogi, ye aapko figure dekh ke idea lagana padega. Theek hai, so this is the mathematical representation of centroid for any structures. Now let us find out the centroid of some shapes which are of most common used. So let us take a rectangle first. So you have taken a rectangle. This is B, this is D. So पहले से कैसे सेंट्रोइड बना दो. दिस इज बी एंड दिस इज डी. नाउ लेट दिस बी योर रेफरेंस एक्सिस. द डिनोमिनेटर लेट दिस बी योर रेफरेंस एक्सिस. सो इफ दिस इज एन एक्सिस एट अ डिस्टेंस एक्स, एट अ डिस्टेंस एक्स, let me take an element having a thickness dx. At a distance x from the reference axis, let me take an element having a thickness dx. So x bar, so sorry, this will be y. This is y. With reference to the x-axis, you will find a distance y. With reference to the y-axis, you will find a distance x. So at a distance y from any reference axis, we have chosen our base as our reference axis. Let us take an element which is having a thickness dy. This d is the depth of the entire section, b is the breadth of the entire section. So y bar is given by integral x dA divided by integral dA. This is the standard formula that we have already derived just now. So what is dA? Now dA is the area of the elemental strip. So the area of the elemental strip is how much? D dy. Ye dy hai. Dy is the thickness and B is the width. So it is B into dy. So the elemental area is B into dy. One more string. Okay. So dA is B into dy. Let us put this into a standard form. So the y bar is given by y into B into dy divided by integral B into dy. Now let us write down the limits. So the limits here are the element extends from 0 to d, and similarly here also the element extends from 0 to d. Okay, so if you integrate this, b is constant, b bahar aa gaya, y dy is y square by 2. We need to put the limit 0 to d. Here it is b into dy, so b into y, again we will be putting the limit 0 to d. So you have y bar is equal to, if you put the limits, it is BD square by 2 divided by B into D. So this is reduced to D by 2. So you can write this as Y bar is equal to D by 2. Y bar is equal to D by 2 for a rectangular section. तभी हम कहते हैं कि height के आधे पे लाई करेगा. ठीक. Similarly, let us do this for x axis. Let this be a reference axis. This is B, this is D. From this reference axis, at a distance of x, at a distance of x, let us say you have an element of thickness dx. So x bar is given by integral x dA divided by integral dA. So So what is dA now here? dA will be d into dx. D is the depth, dx is the width. So d into dA, d into dx is your dA. Let us put it into this standard formula. So you have x bar is equal to d into dx divided by integral d into dx. The limits of integration extend from 0 to b. So if you integrate this, you have or x bar is equal to b by 2. So for a rectangular section, the centroid lies at a distance. If you have chosen the edges as the origin, then the centroid lies at a distance of b by 2 and d by 2. Now let us find out the centroid for a right angle triangle. So to find out the centroid for a right angle triangle, first what we are doing is let us take an element which is at a distance of y having a thickness dy. Okay, so this is a very infinitely thin strip, so it can be considered as a rectangle. So let us say that because the width is also variable here, the width will vary from point to point. Here the width is 0, here the width is b. So let us say the instantaneous width is b dash. So dA is given by b dash dy. So to find out b dash, to find b dash, what we need to do is use similar triangles. You can use any methods, ratio, proportion, anything. I am using similar triangles. So if you use similar triangles, it says that b dash by b is equal to, what is this distance? This is h minus y divided by y. H minus y by h. So this is h minus y divided by h. So b dash, therefore, b dash can be written as b into h minus y divided by h. So now dA transforms to b into h minus y divided by h into dy. So y bar is given by integral y dA divided by integral dA. So integral y dA is b into h minus y into dy, and standard is y again, divided by integral dA is the sum of total areas. So you can again write this as this is integral b into h minus y divided by h into this is dy. The limits of integration are 0 to h. The element starts at 0, ends at h. Here also it is 0 to h. So if you integrate this, y bar becomes equal to h by 3. After performing the integration, you will see that y bar is equal to h by 3. Similarly, we can write down x bar is equal to, if it is taken from here, if this is your reference axis, the larger end, it is b by 3. So it all depends upon your reference. If you have chosen the larger end as your reference, it is b by 3. If you choose this, it is h by 3. You can perform the integration and verify it yourself. So for a circular body, for a circular section, it is well defined that center is the location from where all distances are equal. So center is your, is the centroid. The centroid of this, means there is no derivation required. There is a derivation, but wo बहुत ज्यादा ही आसान सा है, अजीब सा, मैंने अजीब सा ना, बहुत आसान सा. नाउ लास्ट इज अ सेमी सर्कल. you see a semicircle, this is a semicircle, and you need to find out the centroid of this semicircle. So to find out the centroid of the semicircle, let us take a element, a strip, which is located at a distance of y having a thickness dy. Okay, so obviously r is the radius of the radius. So if you integrate this, so if you find out y bar is equal to integral y dA standard form divided by integral dA. Now what is dA? Let the instantaneous width be b dash. So this is b dash into dy. Now what is b dash is equal to? B dash is equal to 2 times r square minus y square. It is 2 times r square minus y square, because this entire height is y square. So this till the half, this will be using Pythagoras theorem, r square minus y square, because this is r. Yahan se yahan tak to r hai. So r square minus y square is this much. So 2 times means, twice means you will get this entire length b dash. So if you put it into the standard form, you have y bar is equal to integral 2 times r square minus y square into dy divided by integral 2 into r square minus y square into dy. Yahan ek y aur hai, theek. Now the limits of integration for this is 0 to r, and for this also it is 0 to r. So if you perform the integration, you have y bar is equal to 4 r by 3 pi. Because what is this? Area of the semicircle. So area of the semicircle, this can be reduced to pi r square by 2. Area of the center, the entire area of the semicircle is pi r square by 2. So you have y bar is equal to 4 r by 3 pi. Okay. And x bar lies at the center. Why does x bar lies at the center? Because if you see this diagram in this manner, now to find out x bar, what do you need to do? You choose this as your reference, and this is your element. Now it is symmetrical about x axis, it is not symmetrical about y axis. So x aap jahan pe bhi lenge, it is symmetrical. So agar symmetrical hai to circle ka aadha hoga. So for x bar, ab aapko ye dhyan rakhna hai ki how was the semicircle placed. If the semicircle is placed like this, y bar is equal to 4 r by 3 pi. If the semicircle is placed like this, then you have x bar is equal to 4 r by 3 pi, and you have y bar is equal to center. Okay, so you need to understand that at the time of derivation, what was the location or what was the positioning of your structure. Aisa nahi hai ki you will always remember the answers only. You need to remember how we achieved or how we arrived at these answers.